President Trump's recent behavior, retweeting anti-Muslim videos, peddling debunked conspiracy theories, making LeVar Ball into a national figure, it's raising questions about what's going on in his head. The co-author of The Art of the Deal, the book that for many of you put Donald Trump on the map, he says people inside the White House are worried about what's going on with the president. Let's bring him in. His name is Tony Schwartz. Good to see you, Tony. So what have you heard and what does it make you think?
Well, even if I hadn't heard this, I would think what I think, but I am connected to a large group of psychiatrists now who wrote this book, The Dangerous Case of Donald Trump, and there's a pretty widespread feeling among them that this is a shift that's occurring, that he has one of the people I know received successive calls from two different people from a White House number, so you don't know for sure, but from a White House number saying, we're concerned the president is, in one case, decompensating, which is a psychological term for losing his grip on reality. So they saw something different.
And decompensation is a psychological, but also medical term where what maintains homeostasis, you know, your well-being, that those mechanisms are starting to break down. So that would be suggestive, no matter who they are, that they've done a little research and that they had a concern about whether or not he was well.
Exactly. And I think that's exactly what's happening is there is a small, very small percentage of people in the White House, because I think a lot of them essentially function as either hostages or members of a cult. But I think there's probably still some who, when they hear him say things like that Access Hollywood tape wasn't real, get very anxious because that is completely unmoored from reality. And I think the issue, Chris, is that he has the bizarre advantage of sociopathy. I've been saying that since July of 2016. That's what I think the issue is. He doesn't have a conscience. He doesn't have an internal moral arbiter. So he's willing to say anything, and no guilt or sense of questioning himself ever arises.
The defense is this. He has a conscience. He is as well as you or I, probably better than I. But this is who he is and how he reacts to aggression as he perceives it. You want to mess with him in the media, he will distract with different narratives. He will attack you 24/7. He will think about nothing else, because a fair criticism will be he has a hyper focus on how things affect him. We're not used to seeing that as much in other presidencies. There has been no surrendering the me to the we, but it doesn't make him sick, Tony. Make your side of the case.
That what happens to a person who has very, very deep and vast insecurity is that they are always attempting to prop themselves up. And under the circumstances, he's feeling a kind of pressure on him, on his own sense of security and well-being that is unprecedented. You know, it's one thing to act in this way that you're talking about toward CNN or toward me. It's quite another to do it when Kim Jong-un has just set off a missile that can get to Washington, and he's still acting as if he's in a playground and he's 9 years old and he's taunting the guy across that playground.
But it could go to personality, not competency. But to advance your own case here, let's put up a graphic of what's happened recently and what has driven this speculation. You know, you can read through the bullet points you want, but, you know, as you read them in succession, it does start to ask, why is he messing with such low, you know, such insignificant stuff? Going after LeVar Ball, making him so important. Al Frankenstein, you know, going all after Franken and those accusations, while obviously ignoring the larger conversation about sexual harassment and assault. Going after the NFL time and time again, using such derisive language about black athletes. You know, the way he has defended Roy Moore, the way he has shot down accusers by implication. The Pocahontas stuff, which is just a slur, and how it has tortured the White House into a position of somehow trying not to recognize that fact. And then, of course, most recently, the videos. Now, I still submit that as...
Are you the prosecutor in the case here?
I mean, well, yes. I think you are. I would be more of the defender here, just in terms of, I think you don't want to be so quick to give someone the defense of illness when this is actually completely competent and completely volitional. Doesn't mean it's not really wrong or counterproductive.
That's why sociopathy is a better description than what most people think of as mentally ill, because a sociopath can be very, very effective in the world, can act in a way that appears to be very sequential. So he has an odd blend, I think, of delusion and deflection. The deflection that he does, and that list of things is deflecting from some of his vulnerabilities, some of his big vulnerabilities, most notably Russia, and the, I'm sure, panicky feeling he has that they're getting closer and closer to him on collusion in Russia. So he has that ability to consciously deflect, but he is also, that is fueled by a certain amount of delusion. And that delusion gets greater and greater. In other words, the idea that you get unmoored from reality is reflected when you say you're on tape saying something, but that you already acknowledged was real, and now you say it's not.
I'll give you that. We have harped on the Access Hollywood latest instance very heavily here on the show because it is the most naked lie that I have seen the president tell while in office. There's absolutely no basis for it. It's absurd for him to do it, and it does raise questions as to why he would. Tony Schwartz, appreciate your perspective. Let me know when you get your full degree.
Thank you.